slash author of the book Penetrating the Business. Get a DJ. Right. How's everybody doing? So tonight, I'd like to thank you all for coming out. You're going to be helping me do my one-man show. So you guys are the virgin babies. To get this thing started, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out tonight. So, the book is about me going into the adult entertainment business. As adult entertainer. From a male dancer, to running an after hour, and to going into porn and family and in the adult entertainment business. And the thing that happened, the moment that happened that made me go into the industry. I put the book out, and for a while I was shopping it and I was sending it to different performers. I won't say the name, but different actors. And then all of a sudden, there's a new movie out that's coming out right now. And four people in the movie, I sent my memoir to. I'm like, what? Hold up. I sent my stuff to them. I sent my stuff to her. I sent my stuff to him. Hold up. So I called my friend in the industry. So I was like, hey man, listen, you know, I've sent all my memoirs to these, you know, people for possible, you know, for possible situation, and now they're in a movie about this subject matter. So my friend in the industry, he said, well, I'm gonna tell you what's happened. I know all of them. I know how they work. And the top guy in the movie looks just like you. He said, yeah, they stole your idea. I said, yeah. So he said, it's a couple different situations how we could handle this. And we talked about that. And then I said, but you know what? I'm going to do the one-man show. And we're going to show. So here we are, and I'd like to thank you all for coming out again. So I'm going to start from the beginning. So when I was about 19 or so, I was a lifeguard. And I was in the neighborhood. So I heard some of the girls in the neighborhood say, oh, we're giving a party for such and such. It's her birthday. I said, really? I said, I'm a male dancer. Boy, you ain't no male dancer. I said, yes, I am. I said, I'm a lifeguard and I'm a male dancer. And I said, you know what? I'll dance for free. And as long as you give me tips. So one of the other girls was like, oh, no question. Good, we on. So that went through. So I'm leaving. So I'm like, okay, how am I? I'm in an outfit. How am I going to do this? They went for it. I'm not a male dancer, but they went for it. So how am I going to do this? So I said, okay, cool. I said, I'm a dancer. I know how to dance. I know how to do my thing. I said, I'm just going to go in there. Tell them to turn on the radio. I'm going to dance. And then I'm going to bring a towel. I'm going to bring a towel. Then I'm just going to go into the corner and do my thing. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. So the day came. So I went to the event. They was all there doing their thing. Crazy. You know, women having their fun. So I came in there. And the music got to start DJing. Doing my thing, working my work, getting my grind on. Oh! And they loved it. It turned out successful. I made it on $75. I was like, cool, this is what's up. So, one of the girls at the party, she came up to me afterwards and she was like, do you know Mike, who lives around the corner from you? I said, yeah. I said, you know, he be dancing too. I said, really? I said, okay. So I'm like saying to myself, okay, I gotta hook up with Mike. Cause me and Mike can hook up together, we can start dancing. So the hunt was on. to find Mike. So about a week and a half, I'm on the basketball court. And then who comes on the basketball court? Mike comes up on the basketball court. So I'm like, Mike, hey, what's up, Mike? Come and talk to you. So I said, Mike, give me basketball girls. So I gave him my number, and about a week and a half, he called me. He said, I got a show for us. He said, get ready, I got a show for you. I said, bet. So that show came, and we went to that show, and it was in a residential house, and I get to the show, and there's women all in the party, and women partying, drinking. Just having a good time, plenty of food. So I'm like, wow, this is how it's going to be. So she said, the girl at the park, she said, okay, well, I'm going to take you to your room so y'all can go up and change. So the party at the time was me, Mike, and a well-known dancer in the D.C. area by the name of Prince Machiavelli. So, you know, we go up to the dressing room, and I'm changing up, and we get ready and everything. So I came out because I would go first. So I came out first, doing my thing. And then Mike, by the name, he goes by the name of Black Panther. So he came out, he did his thing, and then Prince did his thing. So the party was successful. We tore the party up, and I was like, wow, this is how it's going to be. So some memorable moments. Was party we did at a trailer park. At a trailer park community. So this trailer park is about 100 miles out. So we driving there. It's like way past King's Dominion. So we driving. Oh man, when are we going to get to this party? So we finally get there. So we pull up in the trailer park community. And we looking for this spot. We looking for the addresses. And these are some big trailer parks. Almost bigger than houses. So we drive and then we hear all this boom, boom, boom. I said, that's it. I said, that's the house right there. So he beeps the girl, because that time people was home. So we find the house and he parks. So then she comes out. So she comes out and greets us. So again, the party is on the hook, the house is booming, women coming in, going out, women hollering, women screaming, they just having themselves a good time. So she comes up and she said, Mike, y'all ready for us? Because we packing there. I don't think y'all ready for us. Mike was like, shit, he gonna tear this joint up. So we walk up to the trailer park and then we go inside the house. So we go inside, the door opens and man, women partying, dancing on each other, cussing each other out, just having a good time. Y'all know how we have a good time. Just having a good time. So I'm like, bet. So we go to the dressing room, and we love going to the parties and making sure that the girls got plenty of food. The first thing we look for is, do they got food? Because afterwards, we home. So we go change up, and the girls off the chain. So I come out, I'm doing my thing, DJ. Mike comes out, he did his thing. And we killed. We had an awesome time. I mean, these girls were really live. We stayed all night. And yes, we got some ass that night. Another memorable party with the blocks. We call the big girls the blocks. We love doing parties with the blocks. Because the blocks got plenty of food and the blocks pay. They got plenty of money. So this is one party, and then, you know, we get there. So we go to the dressing room, and again, I go out first. So I come out doing my thing, DJ! Charge me to hit me up on the ground. I'm like, Mike, get him up off me. Get him up off me, man. Mike is laughing his ass off. So Mike eventually get him up off me. I get him up. I get up. DJ. Doing my thing. I am turning the joint out. I'm taking the bras down. I'm sucking the titties. I'm having a good time. So Mike comes out and he do the same thing. He kills it. So Mike worked at the government building, and he worked at a government building with a lot of women. So we would get parties out their ass. I mean, we were booked all the time. I mean, we were good performers. We were really good performers. And I mean, it was just so many women having referring us from other parties and everything, so we were killing the game. Another party was the party with the fine girls. We hated doing a party with the fine girls. Cause they don't want nobody to know they're a freak. So it was a party on the Myrtle with the basketball, we call this the basketball wives. So this was a party at the Wizards, some of their wives. So we, they fine shit. This is gonna be a bad party. We usually like to go into those parties and get out money and get up out of there. So this particular party, man, we came up in there. I come out first again. DJ. Man, they humping on me. They in front of me. They in back of me. They grabbing in between my legs. I look at Mike and like, she's like, we got one tonight. And we turned it out as usual. We turned it out. So, you know, I always go out first. And it's a reason. Because the desired girl that I would want to come to the back room, I would whisper in her ear. When the other dancer comes out, I want you to give me a plate of food. And it'll work every time. So I come in, oh Mike, I tore it up, man. You sound as I see it. I tore it up. So then I say, you ready? So Mike goes out. So then I go in the room. And I sit on the bed, I put my back to the door, I'm butterballing there. But just with a towel on me. I put the towel. So I look at the door, nobody come. Then I hear a little knock. I got you food. I said, wonderful, thank you so much, thank you. So then I say, so now it's time for a private dance. So I turn around, I give a little private dance. Oh, yes. I'm unbuttoned. The shirt. Bend them over and give them some. So like I said, we became very successful in our little male dancing hustle. I danced for over 15,000 women, maybe more. So now at this time, the firefighters exam was coming out. So I was interested in going into fire prevention. So I took the firefighter's test.
Yeah.
And I was waiting for the results. So the results took forever. So it took so long that the police test came up. So partner and I, we was on the basketball court. He said, hey, well, I'm gonna take the police test. Give me a ride. So I said, cool. So I gave him a ride and I ended up going and taking it with him. I said, well, I'm gonna take it. So I took the test and fucked around and passed. So they doing it, background investigations on me and all that shit. So I end up going to the academy. So while I'm in the academy, guess who else is in the academy? Mike. He said, Mike. No, other women who have seen me dance throughout the year. See me dance at parties and see me dance at the clubs. They in the motherfucking academy too. So word got out that I was a male dancer. So after a block of instructions, you can take 15-minute breaks. So we were taking a break after some block instructions. So I'm in the water fountain to get some water. So then this female sergeant comes up behind me and she says, Cadet, I need to see you in my office. So I follow her. She was fat too. So we went into one of those classrooms. You know how classrooms are, you can see the glass. Yeah. So she said, lock the door behind you. Down at her desk. So I'm in front of her. So she said, how long do you think you could get away with it? I didn't say anything. She said, so you're a male dancer, huh? I'm like, oh, shit. So she said, so how long do you think you can get away with it? I'm still not saying nothing. So she said, oh, what, cat got your tongue? I'm still not saying nothing. I'm sitting there. So she said, do you know I can have your ass out of here for this? I ain't saying nothing. So then she says, so to get out of this, you got to dance for a party. So she said, you're not to say a word of this to anybody, and I will let you know. So I went back to my class, and they was like, man, you all right? I said, oh, yeah, I'm good. I'm good. Yeah, it'd be good. So I ended up dancing for her and two other cadets who was having birthday parties. And that's how that happened. So at the end of the academy, we went to our districts where we were supposed to be assigned. So we're meeting other officers in the station. So two officers come in off of the street with a lockup. So they process and one of them is coming back and forth. Oh, these are new cadets? Oh, okay. Which one the male dancer? Everybody pointed at me. I said, oh, Lord. So, basically, I became the go-to guy for all the female officers who were having birthday parties, bachelor parties, divorce parties, or just parties. Even some of the male officers who you know, who it was, I remember a sergeant came in. He said, hey, my wife need a male dancer. I said, okay. So, another memorable moment. I remember one time I was getting ready to go out to the street. I was gassing up the car, and this male Latino officer came up to me, and I was beside another veteran officer. So he was like, "Hey, I have pictures of you dancing in the nude with women." The veteran officer said, "Man, what kind of faggot shit is that? You talking about you got some naked pictures of a man in your offices?" That lieutenant was like this. He got the hell away from us. He made him look so bad. And every time I saw that lieutenant, that guy could never look me in my face. I would see him coming down the aisle or something in the hallway. That was so crazy. I'm going to take a little 5-minute break, and then we're going to come back, you guys. You guys all right?
Yeah.
Cool. Let's go, DJ.